Number 10, Tech On. In this 2021 storyline, the Red Skull comes into a new power that removes the powers of other heroes. Tony Stark uses his technology to create the Iron Avengers. Captain America, Captain Marvel, Black Panther, Spider-Man, Wolverine, and obviously Iron Man, basically the most popular Avengers, all get Iron Man-like mech suits that they can use to fight against similarly mech'd up villains. The whole thing was basically a partnership with Bandai Namco to create Avenger-themed mech toys. So it has no numerical Earth number. But who cares? The art is sweet, the idea is original, and the toys are kinda cool.
Number 9, Brenda Drago. First appearing in Spider-Girl number 18 in the year 2000, Brenda was forced into a life of crime by her abusive ex-boyfriend. He gave her a suit equipped with functioning wings, and she became the flying thief known as Raptor. However, her crime spree is cut short by Spider-Girl, and the two become fast friends. Similar to Cloud9, she's mostly known for her ability to fly around, but her wings are also razor sharp, making her a formidable aerial opponent. She has been a member of the New Warriors and the Savage Six. She's also married to Spider-Girl's friend, Normie Osborn. It's an alternate universe. Hey guys, before I get down to the next one, please take a second, hit that like button. Really helps us out here at Top 10 Nerd. Number 8, Michael Van Patrick. MVP came onto the scene in 2007 in Avengers The Initiative. See, the scientist who created the Super Soldier Serum for Captain America had also researched a revolutionary diet and exercise regimen, which he theorized would create the ultimate soldier, but it would require a lifetime of adherence to produce the right results. Well, the US Army basically was like, I want my super soldier now! So the scientist scrapped those plans and he started working on perfecting the super soldier serum. When the scientist eventually died, the research was passed down through his family, eventually ending up in the hands of Brian Van Patrick, who raised his son Michael on the principles of that original research. Michael quickly became one of the greatest athletes in America, but lost it all when he fell under heavy scrutiny due to him being the great-grandson of Captain America. It's a tragic hand to be dealt as Michael loses nearly every award he's ever received, even though all of his abilities came from good old-fashioned training. He does find his shine, however, when he joins the Initiative, and in his training, breaks the course record for heroes without super speed. He is pretty awesome, but he does unfortunately die later on. Number 7, Luna Snow. Neat story about her. She technically first appears in the mobile game Marvel Future Fight, released in 2015. But Luna's first appearance in a comic book was in Marvel's War of the Realms event in 2019. She's a South Korean K-pop singer turned superhero. She was on stage performing at Stark Arena when the area was attacked by Joro's spider and her AIM scientists. Luna and her bandmates are taken hostage and she is held inside a cold fusion reactor. When the reactor malfunctions, Luna receives cryokinetic abilities, and she uses them to escape and free her friends, later becoming the hero known as Luna Snow. She later on fights against an invasion of fire demons, freezing the ground beneath them and blasting them with ice shards. Number 6, Roger Brokerage. Also known as Hardball, Roger made his debut in Avengers The Initiative in 2007. Roger grew up in Los Angeles and he wasn't happy when his brother Paul received special powers from the Power Broker, a villain who gives superpowers in exchange for a percentage of the money that you make with them. Worse, Paul gets intensely injured and his family starts to greatly suffer under the weight of his medical bills. So Roger is not too happy about this and decides he's gonna kill his brother. But in the end, he just can't go through with it and decides instead that he's gonna kill the Power Broker. On approaching the Power Broker, however, he is convinced by him to gain some superpowers for himself. And it's super painful, but he winds up gaining the ability to create hard balls of light. He sets out on a mission to rob an armored car, but he ends up rescuing a woman instead. Man, this guy always ends up doing something different than he planned. In the end, he helps defend the president against an attack from Hydra and joins the Avengers Initiative of Nevada, the heavy hitters. Number 5, Wave. Also known as Pearl, she also made her debut in War of the Realms in 2019. She grew up in the Philippines, a promising swimmer with Olympic potential. One day, she is drenched in water that has been exposed to unknown energies, and she gains the ability to control water. She's later taken in by a group of heroes who help her learn how to use her new powers, becoming the superhero called Wave. She eventually becomes part of Triumph Division, the Southeast Asia Initiative. She later confronts the fire giants and their leader, Cinder, who senses Wave's elemental power and attempts to lure her away from her homeland. Her hydrokinesis powers allow her to manipulate water in any form, even solid or gas, making her surprisingly powerful. Number 4. Aero. Also called Lei Ling, Aero made her debut in a self-titled comic in 2018. A Chinese agent from Shanghai, she has powers of aerokinesis, allowing her to generate and control the wind. She was once in a confrontation with Wave from Triumph's division. Like Wave, she had been tricked and lured away from her homeland, leaving it undefended. She is affiliated with the Agents of Atlas alongside 3D Man and Jake O, the new war machine. Her powers allow her to not only fly, but blast bursts of wind from her arms or legs, reportedly strong enough to destroy high-grade concrete. She also has the ability to solidify the air into shapes, like swords or platforms, as well as creating air bombs or generating whirlwinds. She has had her powers since she was a child, and founded her own architecture firm called Sacred Tree Design. Number 3. Crescent. Similar to Luna Snow, this character also first appeared in Marvel's Future Fight mobile game, and later appeared in War of the Realms in 2019. Crescent is a child, weighs 60 pounds, and is a Taekwondo prodigy. She was there when the Agents of Atlas went up against Cinder and her fire giants, but eventually she did become overwhelmed. She has the power of a half-moon bear spirit, and she uses the power of her mask to avoid fire blasts from the fire demons. There's a lot of cool new characters like her in the War of the Realms storyline. I definitely recommend checking it out. Number 2. White Fox. Also known as Amy Han, this character first appeared in Marvel's Contest of Champions in 2015. She is the last of the Kumiho, a mystical shape-shifting nine-tailed fox. Legends say that the fox hunts and seduces men to eat their hearts. Her grandmother was a Kumiho who fell in love with a man, and he helped her discover her humanity. She was raised to hide her true form from others and was super good at it, later becoming an intelligence agent for the South Korean government. She once allied with Black Widow and Domino to help destroy the Creation Constellation, an artifact that can turn humans into celestials. However, the team discovers that White Fox intended to get infected by the constellation in order to gain cosmic power, so they kick her out of the team. She has incredible superhuman capabilities, the full extent of which is still unknown. And here we are at number 1, Kamala Khan.
Number 1. Earth 15513, there was nothing, followed by everything. Swirling, burning specks of creation that circled life-giving suns, God, Doom, created the light. Then there was Earth. The firmament cooled and he raised up a land, this holy land, the world, and upon it he set his kingdoms. Earth 15513, also known formerly as Battle World, and more recently as Battle Realm, is where God Emperor Doom created his new world using the power of the Beyonders after the destruction of the multiverse in the 2015 Secret Wars event. After the final battle between God Emperor Doom and Mr. Fantastic, Battleworld was destroyed and became the center of the new multiverse. The remaining reality became Battle Realm, where the Elders of the Universe, the Grand Master and the Collector, held the Contest of Champions.
Number 10, Cloud9. Also known as Abigail Boylan, this character made her big debut in Avengers: The Initiative in 2007. Abigail was a shy girl from Illinois who came into contact with an alien gas cloud that allowed her to control it. She had no interest in being a hero though, she just wanted to fly around. Destiny soon catches up with her though, and War Machine picks her up and recruits her into the Initiative, a post-Civil War agreement that each of the 50 states have its own superhero squad. She participates in an emergency mission to protect the president from an assassination attempt by Hydra. Fun fact, the president is George Bush in this issue. Cloud9's power is called gaseous aerokinesis, meaning she can generate and manipulate gas, creating multiple clouds for a concealing mist effect or using the gas to suffocate others. I also have this ability. Pretty cool stuff, but the gas is mostly used for flight, allowing her to reach speeds up to 600 miles per hour.
Number 9, Earth 1048. The reality of Earth 1048 is actually the reality seen in the Marvel Spider-Man game that came out on PlayStation, plus its associated comics and novels. Seeing as this game is highly beloved by many Spider-Man fans, including myself, I thought it deserved a mention. The universe first appeared in the Marvel Spider-Man Hostile Takeover novel on August 21st, 2018, which served as a prequel for the events of the game. In case it wasn't clear, this is also the universe featured in Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales, and will be the same world in the next entry to the series, Marvel's Spider-Man 2. All the games so far have had fantastic open world versions of Manhattan, some of the best web swinging in a video game so far, tons of alternate reality and original spider suits, and are all really, really fun. Number 8, Earth 8. First appearing in Spider-Man Volume 2, number 14 in 2017, Earth 8 is a pretty great place. Essentially, it's a possible future of the reality of Earth 65. A utopia where Miles Morales and Gwen Stacy got married and were part of a team called the Amazing Eight, whose members included Spider-Boy and Spider-Girl, Miles and Gwen's kids, Spider-Ham, Penny Parker and her Spider-Mech, Jerry Drew Spider-Man, and an unnamed Spider-Woman that resembled Kraven the Hunter. The Spider-Gwen of Earth 65 came to Earth 8 to ask for the Amazing Eight's help to fight Silk in her reality. Unfortunately, Miles and Gwen were on their second honeymoon, so she only got the Amazing 6 out of 8, but that was enough it seems. Number 7, Earth 2319. Appearing in the New Avengers Volume 3, number 14 in 2014, Earth 2319 is one of the Earths that dealt with the incursion. This Earth had gone through a fourth age of apocalypse, which resulted in the collapse of the Phoenix Eggs, which in turn led to Magneto forming the floating twin cities of Tien, where mutants would be safe. The floating cities ended up being the point of an incursion witnessed by the 616 Mr. Fantastic. An Illuminati team was formed on the Earth that consisted of Mr. Fantastic, Doctor Doom, Black Panther, Yellowjacket, both Captain Britons, Betsy Braddock and Brian Braddock, Iron Man, and Emma Frost. It was basically used as an example of what the Sidera Maris, which are an army of robots created by the mapmakers, could do after they invaded from the incursing Earth, resulting in the eventual destruction of Earth 2319. Number 6, Darkhold Universes. Earth 21129, Earth 42222, Earth 52433, Earth 64211, and Earth 37640. Now, this one point is actually gonna cover multiple different alternate Earths in one, because they are all part of the same event. The Darkhold is basically a codex written on flesh by the elder god C'thone of all his evil works and spells. There is a stone transcription and a series of scrolls that act as the same thing. But when the true Darkhold was found by Victorious and Doctor Doom, it opened a pathway between the other world and our world, and awoke C'thone. In preparation for the coming conflict and to temper them with madness, which is just the dumbest idea I've ever heard of, Victorious and Scarlet Witch had Iron Man, Blade, Wasp, Black Bolt, and Spider-Man all read from the book. The problem was they read too far, were corrupted, and saw horror story versions of their lives, resulting in 5 alternate realities and 5 2021 stories you need to read. Number 5, Earth TRN 891, Dark Ages. In the alternate Earth TRN 891, after a battle with an ancient, powerful, galaxy-attacking robot that was trapped inside the Earth billions of years ago called the Unmaker, Doctor Strange opened a portal to create an EMP that would defeat the Unmaker. This worked, but Strange died before he could close the portal. This resulted in a huge EMP that shut off all electricity on Earth. This led to various wars in the post-apocalypse, killing billions of people. Eventually, things calmed down and people lived in various different communities, surviving against attacks from vampires and werewolves. In Europe, however, the mutant apocalypse had taken over and, using brainwashed geniuses from around the world, began attempting to reawaken the Unmaker for his own villainous deeds. Number 4, Bloodline. In the JJ and Henry Abrams written storyline from 2019, Mary Jane Watson is killed by a villain known as Cadaverous after Spider-Man is swarmed and beaten pretty badly by his minions. 12 years later, the story has a one-armed version of Peter Parker, who is now the honestly pretty bad single father of Ben Parker, Peter and Mary Jane's son, after Cadaverous returns out of hiding and kidnaps Peter to use his blood for his evil plans. It is up to the new Spider-Man, Ben Parker, with the help of his friend Faye Ito, and old Tony Stark and Riri Williams, to fight Cadaverous and his minions, which includes a cyber-zombified team of Avengers. Look guys, in this reality, YouTube has this algorithm thing, right? And when you like and subscribe to us, it signals to the YouTube overlords that we are worthy of being seen by all you lovely people and new people, helping us grow and continue to pump out videos like this one. So I just want to say thanks for doing that for us. We appreciate every like and subscribe you drop. Okay, on to the top three. Number three, Earth TRN 852, Heroes Reborn. When Phil Coulson sold his soul to Mephisto in the 2021 event, Heroes Reborn, he was given an object called the Pandemonium Cube, which he used to warp reality, creating the alternate world of TRN 852. Here, the Avengers were never assembled, instead replaced by the Squadron Supreme of America, which consisted of the heroes Hyperion, Nighthawk, Power Princess, Blur, Dr. Spectrum, and Skymax. Tony Stark never created the Iron Man armor, Carol Danvers never became a hero, Captain America remained a capsule, and the Hulk was banished to the Negative Zone. After the Earth 616 version of Blade ended up on this Earth, he began assembling the Avengers again, starting with Captain Popsicle. Number 2, Earth 001, Home of the Inheritors. First appearing in Superior Spider-Man number 33 in September 2014, Earth 001, or Loomworld, is home to the Inheritors, who are a clan of very strong beings who hunt and feed upon the life force of animal totems, specifically spider totems, meaning all the Spider-Men and women of the Marvel multiverse. Loomworld is also the home to the Master Weaver and the Web of Life and Destiny, which is basically a model of the entire universe and allows for travel to different realities. The Web of Life and Destiny and the Master Weaver were captured by the Inheritor family, who used it to hunt various Spider-Men. The event this takes place in is an awesome one, and if you get the chance, I highly suggest that you give it a read.
And here we are at number one, Kamala Khan. She is most notably known as the protagonist in Marvel's new Avengers game, but Kamala Khan originally burst on the scene in 2013 in Captain Marvel Volume 7. Kamala is a Muslim Pakistani-American teenager from New Jersey, and she takes up the mantle of Miss Marvel after Carol Danvers. As a child, she made friends with a boy named Bruno, and the two bonded over their shared love of the TV series Tween Mutant Samurai Turtles. One night, she goes to a waterfront party against her parents' wishes, gets made fun of by some mean kids named Zoe and Josh, and she goes home sad. Kamala was traveling home from this party at the same time that the Terrigen mists blanketed Jersey City, and the mist put her into a coma where she had a vision of Captain Marvel. She awakens from the mist and is shocked to discover she's been transformed into a polymorph, able to change her body into virtually anything. Anything? Struggling to gain control of her powers, she runs around the neighborhood, eventually winding up back at the waterfront. She's just running around freaking out about having superpowers. She gets back to the waterfront and finds Zoe has fallen into the river. She rescues Zoe and feels really good about it until she gets home and is grounded for sneaking out. She later stops a burglary and discovers she has the ability to heal herself from gunshots just by transforming back to her regular form. Some fun facts about Kamala: her name means perfection in Arabic, and she plays an online game called World of Battlecraft, based on the popular Warcraft games.